Hello everyone, hope you're doing well. Welcome back to a new Flight Simulator 2020 video. Today we're jumping on board the 747, the Queen of the Skies, because I want to show you a mod that has been recently updated. It's called the Salty 747 mod, and the last release is version 3.0, and it brings a lot of improvement to this beautiful aircraft. We can say it's the same work that the fly-by-wire team made on the A32NX mod for the A320, but in this case we're talking about the 747. Okay, let's get inside and I can show you a little bit more about this beast. Okay, so inside we go directly to the FMC or MCDU, depending on how you wanna call it, and we have the menu page here. If we go on salty options, we have the IRS, and we can change the IRS align time. In this case I have everything set up already. Here you can choose between IVAO or whatever you want. Simbrief, you can put your Simbrief ID so you can import your flight plans from Simbrief directly. There's Metar, and you can rely on various sources. Right now I have selected Meteor Blue, which is the same for Flight Simulator. Now we have the 80s, we can use many things. We can change the units to kilogram, but we don't care about that. And here on miscellaneous we can also change the pilot. For example, now there's the one pilot. Right now we have the co-pilot that has four stripes, so two captains, okay, or both. But I highly recommend you to leave it without anyone, because it's quite annoying, at least for me, to have somebody inside, because you cannot really see what you want to look at. So anyway, let's bring it up in the air so I can show you a little bit more. Right now we are all good to go. I spawned on the runway, so I didn't set up anything, because I'm not really good with this plane. I don't know it as well as I know the A320, because it's a bit more complex and old school. Anyway, let's put full power. And release the brake. Okay, so it should call our speeds. So we just wait for it. Right now we are in the airport graveyard in America, because this is where the plane is gonna end up in a few years, sadly. Okay, V1. VR, here I was a little bit too aggressive on the rudder. Positive climb gear up. And we keep it climbing for a bit. I think that the biggest part of the work they've done so far, it's in the FMC, and we're gonna see it now. I'm gonna read you a bit of the change log, because there's so many things and half of them I don't know what they are, because it takes a real pilot to understand exactly what's going on. And yeah, so I'm gonna put autopilot now. Okay, we are climbing now. I can show you a little bit more of the plane. Here we can swap between the modes, map, doesn't work a lot. I don't have a flight plan set, so I probably can't show you a lot. But here we can see there are all the pages. This is pretty much like before. But let me tell you a bit about the changelog, because it's pretty chunky. So, starting from the flight director, the smooth rotation command when VNAV armed and V2 set for takeoff. They added a custom-made Boeing font to FEs. Added option in FMC to switch units, as we saw, from pounds to kilograms. I'm just gonna say some of them, cause really there's a lot. I will leave as usual the link down in the description below for you to try it out yourself, and you can read yourself the complete changelog. What else? They added the Metar and ATIS requests, just like the A320. Simbrief integration, VNAV climb and cruise pages on FMC, but not yet fully functional. The auto throttle now correctly engages in speed mode when leveling with VNAV path. Okay, here we are climbing. You can see from the outside. I actually forgot to remove the flaps, that's why the plane wasn't climbing a lot. Yep, nice pilot. Anyway, now VREF 25 and 30 calculated from current weight using real aircraft data. Flap maneuver speed displayed reflect rear aircraft values for current weight. Speed bug now displays correct value on PFD. And there's loads of these improvements. For example, on the ECAS visual, redesign of all instrumentation on upper and lower ECAS. They added arrows to fuel synoptic to show active transfer. Stub trim indicator now properly functional. New APU running memo message. Auto brake. Parking brake set. All kind of memos. They added the pilots that I will never use, but this makes this plane actually usable, because the only reason that was keeping me away from this plane was that the level of detail was not high enough for me to be interested in this plane, because I tried many times to learn to fly almost in a realistic manner this plane, but there were no features to play with, like the A321X. So it was just sending me away from this nice, interesting aircraft. I mean, it's the most iconic aircraft that could ever be. It's in every movie, and the jumbo jet is famous worldwide, so I think it's time for a landing. Okay, I'll meet you on final approach. Okay guys, final approach with the 747-8. 1000 call out. Okay, let's see how it goes. I'm not really familiar with this plane, as I said. So if I crash, it's not my fault, as usual. It's never my fault. Jokes aside, getting closer. 4 whites means that I'm really, really high. Speed is looking good, more or less. Maybe it's okay. 40, 30, 20. And floating. 10. Okay, touchdown. G. gently the nose down. Let's keep it straight like this. Yeah. Okay. That wasn't too bad. Let's bring it to a full stop and we can call it a day. So guys, this was the 747 Salty Simulation mod. Free add-on. I highly recommend you to try it out, especially because it adds so much more to the simulation and to this aircraft that deserves to be the pinnacle of the flight simulation, no? It's the most iconic aircraft there is, so... Anyway, enough talking, otherwise the video is 9 hours long. As usual, if you enjoyed, leave a like. If you didn't, a dislike, no problem at all. Let me know down in the comments below what do you think, if you have any suggestion for me. And I'll see you in the next one.